Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Welcome to a Tempest Stronghold Exodus Draft, where the main goal is to open Wasteland, which I did not. The secondary goal is to open Rolling Thunder, which I definitely did. The fact that this card's a common is absurd. It's from a bygone era, and I'll go ahead and take it and be happy with it. Rolling Thunder deals X damage divided any way you choose for red, red X. So yeah, it's basically the most ridiculous card you can think of. Well, Overrun's pretty sick too, but I'm actually not going to take it. So my favorite deck in this format is Blue-Red. I also think Rootwater Hunter is amazing, and I actually think green is by far the worst color, so this is actually a pretty good pack because I'm going to get to take Rootwater Hunter and pass Overrun, hopefully putting the person to my left into green. Aftershock's also decent too, but Rootwater Hunter is very good, so yeah. I started with a common fireball that, well, like, way more than a fireball, a common, you know, X spell that divides up, and then a common Tim, a Prodigal Sorcerer, so I would say things are looking pretty good here. Alright, pick three, you've got, Broken Legacy card Alurin, Rootwalla as one of the better cards in the pack, but there's also Time Ebb and Whispers of the Muse. It's actually kind of close. There's also Lowland Giant, which is decent, but not great. I think I'd rather take Time Ebb over Giant, but I'm not actually sure if I should take Whispers of the Muse over Time Ebb. In a slow game, Whispers of the Muse is very good. Yeah, you know what, I'm going to take Whispers of the Muse. I like drafting sweet buyback spells. Alright, now I'm probably taking Time Ebb, though File Marid is actually not that bad. 1-3 Flyer, and it can't be blocked very easily. But I think Whip Tongue Frog in Exodus does a pretty good job of, you know, making it so you don't need Phylomerids. More Rootwallas. Jeez, the person on my right is definitely not green. Yeah, I'm going to take Time Ebb. I mean, again, I like Lowland Giant, but Time Ebb offers you something a little different and better. Oh, more good green cards, but who cares? I actually wouldn't have minded being green in this particular draft, but I still like the cards I have. So Urtai's Meddling basically just gives a card Suspend X. So they play a spell, you meddling it for 3, it's like it has Suspend 3. There's Sandstone Warrior, which is actually fairly strong. And then there's Firefly, which is the name of a great canceled TV show. I don't think I'm taking Firefly. Actually, I'd rather have Sandstone Warrior. It's just a much better blocker. Leaving up Sandstone Warrior when you have Whispers of the Muse seems like an unbeatable combo. Sea Monster's a good blocker, too, but Sandstone Warrior is much cheaper, so I think that's why it's worth taking. All right. Cashing in now. Dreamcash is quite good. It's basically a draw 3, put 2 lands on the bottom, which is good in a long game. Like I said, I don't need Phylomerid. I actually don't like Thalakos Mistfolk because I don't like any of the cheap shadow creatures because I'm not planning on attacking my opponent pretty much ever. So, yeah, this is exactly the kind of deck I draft in this format. I mean, I don't always end up here, but based on how I draft and the cards I prioritize, I end up here a lot. Ooh, I like Mannequin too. Mannequin is actually very good. Phyrexian Splicer is cute. I mean, it takes a bunch of different abilities off one creature and moves them to another, but I'm just going to take Mannequin. I actually don't hate Coiled Tin Viper either, but Mannequin's really good with buyback spells. It's just a good ramp card that, you know, you can add to decks in colors that normally do not get ramp. Ooh, some late blue and red cards. There's a lot of good ones. I actually like Flowstone Dine a lot, but I think I'm just going to take the Mog Fanatic here. It's a way to protect yourself against, like, cheap shadow creatures, and this deck's already, you know, kind of on the slow side, so I think it's safe to just grab that, or safest rather, to grab that. And none of these cards do anything. I guess I'll take Disenchant because maybe that could be a sideboard card. Actually, maybe I should have taken Manta Rider just so no one thinks that blue is open, though. How could they think blue is open? I've cut it so hard. And wow, Mana Vortex is very good. It's a spider that can block additional things, but I'm just going to take Giant Crab. Giant Crab, not a card I'm hoping to play, but it's a card that, still is useful to have. I mean, there are some decks where Giant Crab's okay, just a 3-3 that sometimes can get Shroud. Ooh, I'll take a Stinging Lizard. Lizards are complicated. I probably shouldn't even bother trying to explain them because they're so ridiculous, but long story short, what Stinging Lizard does is I can block a creature and then hop onto another creature, so it's kind of like a bad regenerator. I guess I'll just take Boreas Curse just to cut blue. Ooh, Sea Monster came around. Ooh, so did Firefly. Close-ish. I'm just going to take the Sea Monster. think it's enough better of a blocker that I would just rather have that. Alright, well, no Wastelands, but a very good pack otherwise. I mean, the fact that I got Rootwater Hunter and Rolling Thunder, and then Dreamcash and Whispers as card draw, then Time Ebb and Mog Fanatic as ways to survive, Mannequin as ramp, and then Stancer Warrior and Sea Monster as, like, decently sized creatures means that this pack actually almost could not be better, besides a Wasteland, of course. Well, that's a very powerful card for someone. Grave Pact is insane. And so is Spike Colony. Spirit Encore is very good. I'm just going to take the Mana Leak. It's just an effective 2-drop. And it's good against buyback spells, something like Brush with Death or someone else has Rolling Thunder. You have to be pretty lucky to have Rolling Thunder, though. So I think Mana Leak actually does what I want. Shifting Wall's not bad either, but Sea Monster's already kind of like a Shifting Wall. I mean, I can't cast it on turn 4 or 5, but still just a big blocking dork, whereas Mana Leak provides me something that I really need, which is a 2-drop, and another thing, which is a way to answer buyback spells. Ooh, what do you got here? I like Hammerhead Shark, but I really like Wall of Tears. Wall of Tears, its name is pretty apt. When your opponent tries to attack into it, they're not going to be happy. No other blue or red cards that are good. Fling is not great in this deck, so alright, Wall of Tears it is. Seeing some good black cards here, but my blue and red cards are both so good that I don't think I should switch, even though I really only have 3 red cards, but Rolling Thunder is just such an absurd card. Ooh, there's Sift. This is exactly what I'm looking for, too. Foil Wall Blossom is kind of cool, though. And I actually like Dream Prowler, but definitely not passing up on a Sift. Sift pretty much makes it so I don't need any more card draw at this point, because I have Whispers, Dreamcash, and Sift. Not that I'm saying that I won't take other card draw, but I don't need it, strictly. Lots of Brush with Death, which is kind of annoying. Also, Bottomless Pit is not a card I want to play against. There's Mog Flunkies, but I don't end up with enough creatures to make them that good. There's also Flowstone Shambler, which is fine. A 2-2 that can turn into a 3-1 is actually pretty good. But there's also Dream Prowler, and I actually like Dream Prowler a pretty decent amount. You can get both these pretty late, and I think the other Dream Prowler might wheel, but I'm still going to take the Dream Prowler, just because it's a fine card. Well, I think I just do the reverse pick now. I mean, I like Mog Maniac and all that, but I'm not damaging my opponent enough to make that good. So I'd rather just take the Flowstone Shambler. Took Dream Prowler last time, but I want to actually have a good curve, so Shambler it is. Alright, what do we got here? Ooh, Sword of the Chosen. That seems like gas. I'm actually just going to take Wall of Razors. This card seems good. I've got a lot of walls, but I also have a lot of ways to win when I have a bunch of walls in play, which is kind of the whole point of the whole exercise. I'm really not going to play Craven Giant, so I actually think I take Spike Worker? No, I take Mind Peel. Mind Peel is actually a card that could potentially beat me. And, ooh, Intruder Alarm. That's a combo with various things. Wall Blossoms is good. There's millions of Brush with Deaths. I don't think I'm using Intruder Alarm here. I guess I'll take Leap. Leap on, like, Wall of Razors seems like a pretty sweet combo. And I hope I don't play against someone who's got a million black buyback cards. But if I do, I'm sure I'll figure out something. Like attacking with Dream Prowler over and over again. And I guess I could take another wall. I mean, Furnace Spirit is a way to kill them, but it's not a really good way to kill them. Though I guess Leap Furnace Spirit could be a thing. Shifting Wall is fine, though. I mean, how many walls do I really need? I guess I have, like, millions already. And there's millions of Brush with Death, too, but I'll just take the Shifting Wall. Alright, I've had enough of this. I'm just taking this Brush with Death. I think I'm more likely to lose to Brush with Death than I am to lose to Lab Rats. You know, I really don't need a second Shifting Wall or a Duck Crawler or a Tidal Surge. Definitely not a Craven Giant. But I could use a Cannibalize for my sideboard. It does kill anything, which is nice. And I have a sideboard plan now with Brush with Death and Cannibalize and Mind Peel. I don't know what I'd side those cards in against, but it's potential. Ooh, Flowstone Shambler. Alright, don't mind if I do. Let's take Mulches. I like having old pictures of Mulch in case it ever gets reprinted and I want to use it. I don't need Heartstone. Alright, so we've got enough playables that I'm not too worried about picking up, you know, a total number of playables. And power levels here, so just need some sweet cards. Well, Hatred is a constructed all-star. It's actually a very strong card if you're... It's Channel plus Fireball, so obviously I like it, but I'm not really interested in taking that. Duffy Cutthroat's a fine sideboard card. See, so Keeper of the Flame. So if they're at more life, this is just pings them for 2. That's fine. I really don't want to take any of these cards, honestly. But I guess I have to take one of them. I mean, Keeper of the Flames doesn't seem good. I don't see myself using that to win the game. And Thalicos Scout. Guess I'll take Thalicos Scout, even though I don't really want to play it. All right, well, I don't want to play Treasure Trove, because I've got so much in that vein. So I'll take Merfolk Looter. It's at least cheaper. I actually think Looter is quite good. Walled Nets is cool. It Oblivion Rings anything that that attack it. But it's double white, so not taking it. And Reckless Ogre is actually not bad at 4 mana, 6-2. But Looter is just so strong. Alright. Slaughter, come on. This card is so ridiculous. Every time I see that card, I wonder why anyone would ever pass it. Can I take Slaughter? The thing is, it's worse than Rolling Thunder, and my other black cards aren't good enough, and I can just take Merfolk Looter. It's a shame that I was not able to pick up an Anarchist. Given all my card draw, I should be able to find Rolling Thunder very often, and having a way to bring it back would have been insane. This pack's not been actually that great so far. I mean, Merfolk Looter is a fine card, but I feel like my deck does need another good thing or two to do. That or Anarchist is in this set and not the last set, so I'm now windmill slamming it. I mean, Oath of Scholars would be good, considering that I have been called a scholar many times, but I would rather have more cards in hand. And I'd rather take Anarchist, because that is exactly what this deck needs. Alright, I feel a lot better about this deck. Now, I can dig through my deck and just double Rolling Thunder them out. Before, I was a little worried that I wouldn't quite have enough action to end up winning here. So, yeah. I mean, this looks pretty good. I guess I'm probably not playing Stinging Lizard either, so I do want to pick up a couple of cards, but I'm happy to play 18 land with double Looter Whispers. I also don't even really need this leap here. What do we got? Proxism. Oh yeah, this card is not great. I guess you put it on their creature and they have a 40% chance of dying, but if it doesn't die, it just whacks you for an additional 3. I think I'd rather just take a Hill Giant. Hill Giant's actually just going to do what I need it to do. Try to take this leap out for a moment. Though it's actually good flyer defense. Maybe I don't need a Wall of Tears, Wall of Razors, and Shifting Wall, but I kind of like walls. There's a Treasure Trove. There's also a Sonic Burst. Sonic Burst is not a terrible card. It's a 2-for-1, which kind of sucks. There's also Treasure Trove. I really can't justify taking Treasure Trove, given that I have Whispers, Double Looter, Sift, and Dream Cache. There's Whiptongue Frog, which I like a lot. I always want a Whiptongue Frog in my deck. It just stops all the 2-2 flyers. But I feel like I can always pick up Whiptongue Frog. The question is, do I even want Sonic Burst in my deck? Yeah, I really don't. I'm just going to take Whiptongue Frog. I know I can get more of those. I know I probably should have just taken the Sonic Burst because, you know, I would be able to get one of the frogs anyway. But I don't see myself playing Sonic Burst. And, ooh. Keeper of the Mind, on the other hand. This card is actually a beating. You play this on turn 2, and then on their draw step, you can just use it to draw extra cards. Jeez. Someone drafting black has some nice cards here. This is basically a first strike death touch creature, which is pretty strong. I don't think I need another Furnace Brute as much as I need another way to draw cards. I guess I'll take Paroxysm just in case I run into something that I can't beat otherwise. Keeper of the Flame. You know, I'd rather just take Dizzying Gaze here and to have a good sideboard card against flyers. Dizzying Gaze plus Leap, bam. What am I taking out? Probably Thalicos Scout. I mean, maybe I have too much card draw, but I don't know how that's possible, so I'm just going to take out Thalicos Scout. Ooh, Reckless Ogre? Don't mind if I do. Now I might be able to cut something else for that. Maybe I cut the Shifting Wall because I've got a Wall of Tears and Wall of Razors already. Don't really need a Shifting Wall in Dream Prowler. Ooh, Fugue I don't really want to play against. I mean, I could cut Whispers of the Muse. That's also an option, but I kind of like it, so I think I'm just going to play. And I definitely want to play 18 land here. We'll take the Raging Goblin. If I play against a lot of X1s, I might want to play it. I'll take Flowstone Flood. Maybe I'll sidebend it against someone and lock him out. Ooh, Cursed Flesh is actually playable. Ruben Mirrors actually is not. Alright. Well, this deck looks pretty sick. Yeah, that's one of the things I actually really do like about version 4 is I'm actually done deck building now. I'm playing 10 Islands and 8 Mountains. Yep, sounds perfect. There's really not much else to say. I mean, I guess Leap is the last card or Shifting Wall. One of those two cards I could see playing, but I've got things under control here.